This is part three of how to solve absolute value equations. In parts one and two, we found out that the way to solve the absolute value of something equals k, where k is greater than zero, is to solve these two equations, stuff equals k and stuff equals negative k. Now, by the way, you never see it written as stuff when you are looking in a regular textbook. They'll usually write it more formally and saying, okay, absolute value equals k can be solved by writing x equals k or x equals negative k, but I like to just use stuff or junk or something like that expression in the absolute value to get the idea to everybody. So these are basically saying the same thing. But now we're going to look at the example where k is not greater than zero. All right, look at this example. Absolute value of 2x minus 3 is equal to negative 9. Now, notice this time you have an absolute value equaling to a negative number. That's impossible because the absolute value of something is greater than or equal to zero because we're talking about distance. So, this is a big warning. You can't solve this. You cannot have an absolute value equaling to a negative number, so stop and just write no solution. Looks like a V. Okay, that's the answer. You don't have to do anything. Now, if you didn't notice this and you wrote 2x minus 3 equals 9 or 2x minus 3 equals negative 9 and you went and solved that equation, when you checked it, you would hopefully find out it will never give you a solution. So the quick way is to just stop right there. So what about if you had 3x squared minus 5x plus 2 plus 4 equals 0? Well, notice that the absolute value is not isolated on one side of the equation. So first we're going to have to subtract 4 from both sides. So we have this, and there it is again. You can't have the absolute value of something equaling to a negative number. So again, you could stop right there and write no solution. Pretty easy, right? All right, let's look at the second kind of a problem. What if you had 2x minus 6 in the absolute value equaling 0? How would you solve this? Well, the absolute value of what will give you 0? There's only one thing. There's only one number that's 0 spaces away from 0, and that's the number 0 itself. So the part in here has to equal 0, actually. So anytime you have an absolute value equaling to 0, you could just write whatever's in the absolute value equal to 0 and solve that. And that's easy to solve. We'll just add 6 to both sides and then divide by 2. And that's easy to check. Let's go ahead and just check it. We take the original problem and we're going to plug in 3 for x. So we have 2 times 3 minus 6 in the absolute value. And we're going to simplify inside the absolute value until we get a simple number, which is 0. And then the absolute value of 0 is 0. And we've got 0 on the other side. And there you go. So for this problem, x equals 3 is the solution. So let's summarize. All right, so we've got three cases. How we would solve the absolute value of some stuff is equal to k. Either k is a negative number, that's when it's less than zero, automatically there will be no solution. The second case, k is actually equal to zero, in which case the stuff in the absolute value has to equal zero. Or the third case, which is the first case we actually worked on, is if k is greater than zero, you're going to solve these two equations. You're going to take the stuff in the absolute value, you take off the absolute value signs, right? To write this. So the stuff equals k or the stuff equals negative k. All right, so notice that in all of these cases, you have the absolute value sign isolated on one side of the equation equaling to some number. All right, here's an example. Solve the absolute value of 2x minus 5 plus 3 equals 9. Now I'm going to show you a classic mistake. And then I'm going to ask you what I did wrong. All right? So I'm going to write 2x minus 5 plus 3 equals 9, or 2x minus 5 plus 3 equals negative 9. Can you figure out the mistake here? The mistake is, it wasn't in one of the forms I just gave you, where the absolute value is isolated on one side of the equation. So you cannot just say everything on the left equals 9 or everything on the left equals negative 9. That's classic mistake number one. Now, let's just see why this isn't going to work. Let's go through and solve the one on the right. So we have 2x minus 2 equals negative 9. Then we're going to add 2 to both sides to get 2x equals negative 7. Divide both sides by 2, and x equals negative 7 halves. So we're going to just check negative 7 halves into 2x minus 5 in the absolute value sign equals 9. So let's do that. We're going to put 2 times negative 7 halves plus 5. That all goes in the absolute value sign. And then inside the absolute value sign, we can cancel the 2's to get negative 7 plus 5. And then in the absolute value sign, we get negative 2, right? And then what's the absolute value of negative 2? That's 2. And what's 2 plus 3? 5. And does that equal 9? No. So hopefully that convinces you that that didn't quite work out, just to write 2x minus 5 plus 3 equals 9, or 2x minus 5 plus 3 equals negative 9. All right, so that's classic example number one. If you forget to isolate your absolute value sign, you're probably going to have some trouble. Let's look at another classic example. Actually, not a classic example. Let's look at another classic mistake. So this is classic mistake number two. Classic mistake number two is you might start off by isolating your absolute value sign, which is great, by subtracting 3 from both sides. Okay, so in other words, go ahead and subtract 3 from both sides so that you would get this equation. All right. Now, everything's fine. That's okay to hear. Okay so far. And then you solve this one. 2x minus 5 equals 6, and you add 5 to both sides, get 2x equals 11, get x equals 11 halves when you divide by 2, and then a lot of people say, oh, so the answer is 11 halves and negative 11 halves. Okay, the mistake here is you only solved one equation and just put a minus sign in for the answer. There's your problem. You can't do that. You have to solve two equations. You can't just solve one equation and then just put a minus sign in front of the other answer. Now we're going to show you why this does not work. All right, let's say you're trying to check this. We're going to just check that x equals negative 11 halves. So we have 2 times negative 11 halves minus 5. And simplifying inside the absolute value, that gives you a negative 11 minus 5. And negative 11 minus 5 is negative 16. And the absolute value of negative 16 is 16. But on the right-hand side, you got 6. No. So this is not correct, right? That is not the correct answer. So those are two classic mistakes that you want to be careful of, right? Let's do one more example. How about we do this problem right? We're going to isolate the absolute value first to get get absolute value of 2x minus 5 equals 6. And then we break it up into two equations to solve since the number on the right is positive. So 2x minus 5 equals 6 or 2x minus 5 equals negative 6. Those are the two equations to solve. I don't have time on this video to solve them, but this is what you should get. X equals 11 halves or x equals negative 1 half. And then you should be able to check both of these in the original absolute value equation above. All right, go on to the next video and we'll work on some more problems and examples.